Okay, so this video is on body shells, so I'm going to take you through all the steps to get a new body shell prepared. And first of all, what I'm going to do is just take you through what tools you'll need, and then we'll go from there. So you'll need two different kinds of scissors. So these are the curved type here, which are good for getting around corners and details. So you'll definitely need a pair like that. This is just a standard straight pair of scissors. You might also need a scalpel blade just for finishing off. The other thing you'll need is a reamer. So this is for doing the holes for the body posts. So definitely recommend getting one of these. Makes a nice neat job. You've got to be careful, but they do work really well. This is a chamfer tool for chamfering the top of body posts and also cutting them. Not essential, but not a bad thing to have. You'll need a Sharpie pen or a permanent marker for marking out wheel arches and body post locations. And this is a template for cutting out the wheel arches, so I'll show you how to use this. This is the Schumacher one. Also good to have a ruler and maybe some vernier gauges just to check the height of the body shell. So the shell I've got that I'm going to use today is a Zoo Racing Anti. So this is the thinner version. So this is 0.5, I think. So it's a little bit more tricky to cut. It's not very forgiving. So you do have to be careful. It's also not very forgiving in a race, but they are a little bit lighter. So it's about 15 grams lighter than the standard one, I don't know. It's a marginal gain, but they don't last as long. So why do a new body? So you can see my old one has been a bit battered, so I had a crash last race, and you can see it's split there, and then it's all damaged at the front here, and just not too bad, but looking a bit bashed up. So I'm gonna do a new shell. It's the same design as this. And what I'm gonna do now is start the cutting. So I'm gonna cut just along this line here. So I'm just gonna do a standard setup here. I'm not gonna do anything clever with the height. I'm gonna cut along the line you can see there. Obviously not gonna do the wheel arches yet. I'll cut those out later. So I'm going to cut out the body shell, cut out the wing, we'll go to the next step after I've done that. One final thing before that, make sure your car's ready to race. So the right ride height, get your battery in, everything ready to go. So the car's sitting right so you can check the heights correctly. That's really important. Okay, so I'm going to get that shell cut out and I'll see you in a minute. Okay, so I've got the body shell all cut out now, and we're ready for the next step. I've done the wing as well. I'm not going to paint the wing, so that's pretty much ready, except for making the holes and taking the protective film off. So we'll leave that aside for now. So what I've done with the body shell is I've got a mark here, which is the center line of the front axle, and I've done another mark here, which is about 5 millimeters back. So that's I'm going to line the second line up with the front axle, and that will push the body shell forward just a little bit to give me more steering. So you can adjust it how you want. Maybe try it on the center line first, or up to you. But I've marked the front axle out. I'm not going to worry about the rear. So I'll line it up on the front axle, mark out where the posts are, and then we're good to go. So another thing is just bear in mind you've got the wing end plates there, so just be careful and cut those out a little bit later on. Don't throw those away. So let's have a look at the post mounting. So I lay the body shell on the car like that, and we're just gonna line it up with that second line on the front axle. So That side's about right, and that's okay. Next thing to do is just have a look at the spacing between the body shell and the wheel, and just make sure it's the same on each side. So it's central, smooth back over a little bit. When you adjust the back, the front might move a little bit as well. There you go, it's moved forward, so I'm just going to slide it back into position. Okay, so that's about right. So I'm just going to always check it hasn't moved. Yeah, that one's moved. Just tweak it there. Okay, so I'm going to mark the post there. Then the rear. So what I usually do is cut the front posts first and then put it on the car and then cut the rear posts as a second step. So I'm going to use the body reamer now and cut the front holes out really carefully. So these things are quite sharp and they go through the body really quickly, especially the thin ones. So you've got to be really careful. Just keep your fingers either side so you don't hurt yourself. Just get it started. Okay, just pause. It's useful to have an old body post here so you can check the diameter without having to put it on and off the car. Need a little bit more. Yeah, that's okay. There should be no resistance. Should be able to move through the hole freely. You don't want any resistance. I might need to open that up a little bit later on. So let's do the second one. And then we'll see how that sits on the car. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so I've got both front holes cut out now. And let's just slot those on the car. Now we're just going to check that the rear holes are in the right place. They still look good. It's important that the body slides into place without any resistance, so you can see it's just falling into place naturally. You don't want any binding on the body post, so that looks fine. So I'm going to cut out the rear holes now, and then we'll move to the wheel arch marking out. Okay. So we've got the front and the rear holes done now. You can see that's lining up nicely, and it's sitting on the car just right. You can see it falls into place on its own, so that's a good fit. Next job is marking out the wheel arches. So we're going to use this Schumacher template here. So line it up with the front axle. This part sticking up is always pointing towards the middle of the car. So it goes like this for the front wheel, and then you flip it around the other way when you do the back wheel, and you get a nice shape on the wheel arches. So let's get the front wheel done. So we just line it up like that. This hole lined up with the axle. And then we just mark it out with the Sharpie. Okay, that's one. Okay, so I'll do the same on the other side and then we'll go to the next step. Okay, so we've got the wheel arches marked out, the holes cut. So we're nearly ready to mask up for painting, but there's one more job I'd recommend you do before that, and that's to clean the inside of the body shell. Although it looks clean, there's all kinds of bits of dust and there could be oily marks or fingerprints that you can't see, and they're going to stop the paint from sticking onto the body shell when you spray it. So what I usually do is get some kitchen degreaser like Silit Bang or fairy liquid and warm water, and just give the inside a good wash, and then if you're in a hurry you can dry it with a hairdryer or just leave it overnight. I wouldn't recommend you use paper towels, because if you dry it with paper towels, you're going to leave little fibers here which is going to get stick to the shell and affect the paintwork. But so I'm going to get that all cleaned up, and then we'll be ready for masking. Okay, so the body shell's been washed on the inside, it was dry, and I've masked up the windows, as you can see. I've cut out where the wing end plates are, so they're not going to be sprayed. So I've put those aside, and also what I've done is I've sprayed on a thin coat of metallic white, because I want a metallic effect on the spray job I'm going to do. So that gives quite an interesting effect. You can see it's still translucent, but it'll make any colour that you spray behind it metallic. So it's quite a cool effect. So something you might want to try. So we're leaving the wheel arches in place, so we're not going to cut those out until the very end. So leave those as they are, except where I've cut the wing end plates out. So the next step is you can either just spray it up if you want a solid colour, or if you want to do something with stencils, then now's the time to get those in place. I haven't got an airbrush, so anything I do is just with stencils. So I've got some things here to show you. So I get stencils from RC Identity. They do a really good range of stencils, decent price. Good delivery. So you can see here there's some different size stars, circles, and then some other sort of body patterns. Maybe you can see there that you can put on, have an interesting effect. See, I've used them there, on there like this, and same with this one, same kind of thing. So you can personalize it a little bit without too much trouble. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to put the stencils on, then I'm going to spray the first colour, and then we'll see how it's turning out. Okay, so the body's sprayed up. I've still got the protective film on, so we can still see the markings that we need to cut the wheel arches out. And next job is to do exactly that. So we're going to cut the wheel arches out. I'm going to take the window masking off and do a window tint on the inside. But yeah, what I've done with the spray is I did the bluey colour, took the stencils off, did the orange, and then I've just sprayed a backing coat of white to bring the colours out. So anyway, it's okay, it's not perfect, but it's good enough for a race shell for me. So I'm going to cut the wheel arches out, and then we'll get the body on the car, then we've got to do the wing, and we're nearly there. So I've got the wheel arches all cut out now, and the body is fitting quite nicely on the car. I had to remount these holes a little bit more, just so that there's no resistance. You can see now it's just sitting nicely by itself, so that's good. We've got the window tint on. So things to do now, just make sure the car's at your race ride height, and just take a couple of reference measurements. So take a measurement from the ground to the edge of the rear part here. Make a note of that. And what you can do then, if you write that on your setup sheet, you can remember the height of the rear and when you make some changes to affect the downforce, you've got a good reference point there. So make a note of that. What we're going to do next is get this protective film off now, because we've cut out the wheel arches, we don't need it anymore. So let's just take this off. One other thing I did was I just trimmed this front fender down a little bit. I shaved about 3 millimeters off that just to give it an extra bit of clearance. And also just check with your wheels on full lock that you've got good clearance around the front wheel arches as well, so it's not binding when you're steering. Let's get the film off. Okay. So some cars have body stops here. You can see these little ball joints, so you can adjust those to prevent the body from binding on the tire. I've got those set low. They're not actually doing anything at that height. You'll notice as well, I've got these adjustable body mounts, so you can make quick height adjustments on the front and the rear. But you can also do it with the snap pin type by just moving an up and down a hole. But these enable a little bit more fine adjustments, so they're quite nice. But they are quite expensive because they're X-ray and all their stuff's expensive for some reason. Okay, so let's get that on the car. All right, so next thing to do is get the wing on. Be really careful when you ream out the holes for the wing. Just be very, very careful, especially this is a 0.5 shell, so not a lot of thickness there, so you can easily cut a hole that's too big. So also don't forget to take the protective film off the wing, especially if you're going to glue end plates on here. If this is still on, they won't last very long. Okay, so we're going to ream out the holes for the wing in the body and the wing itself. You can see the markings here. You can experiment with putting the wing further back. I'm just going to put that straight through the center hole and keep it nice and simple. And then we're almost there. So the body's all done now. I've got the wing on and done the stickers. As you can see, it's all trimmed up. So let's just get it on, final check. You can see it goes on nice and easy. So if I lift it up and let go, there's no resistance there, which is great. That's just what you want. So we're all ready to race. Hope you found that useful, and hope this body shell's lucky tomorrow.